The Seattle University's law school depriving its students of real-world work experience, deciding to suspend its externship program with ICE after a complaint by a student who then filed a petition.
Yep, one student, an email from the school's dean to students saying in part, quote, "I am suspending our externship placement with ICE. Based on its current policies and practices, as educators, lawyers, and soon-to-be lawyers, we hold particular power and bear a special responsibility to be peacemakers and to assist those who are suffering due to the unjust operation of our legal system, laws, and their enforcement." Here to react, campusreform.org correspondent and third-year law student at Seattle University School of Law, Thomas Reinhardt. Thomas, thank you very much for being here this morning. So you heard what the dean had to say. This externship has to end because it's unethical as lawyers to work with ICE. What do you say to that?
Well, to me, it seems a little bit hypocritical. You know, they always try to hide behind their Jesuit values and saying that that precludes them from being able to allow students to extern with ICE. But, you know, we brought up with the administration just a couple of weeks ago that ICE does a lot more than just enforce our borders. They enforce the drug trafficking, international child sex trafficking. So there are a lot of social justice issues that ICE actually tackles. So it's really disingenuous and just seems to me to be just a political maneuver because they disagree with the president's enforcement of border policy.
Thomas, the program director actually gave a statement on the suspension, saying students raised concerns after ICE presence at our annual externship fair caused them to feel unsafe. We believe a real possibility exists that placing a student in an ICE externship may force them to act unethically or unlawfully. What's your response to that statement?
Yeah, well, you know, we've seen this a lot over throughout other college campuses. The Leadership Institute's campus reform has done a great job of reporting on that. But what's really interesting is that in a law school, we're faced with these same issues with our student body, where people feel unsafe, and it's. Frankly, there's no justification for that when we're lawyers that are being trained on the rule of law, being trained on, you know, knowing both sides of an issue. So to me, it just seems like, why would we want to limit student opportunity? We're not forcing students to extern with ICE, but that opportunity should be available for students who want to pursue
That's
a path
right.
in law
mm-hmm.
enforcement.
It's, yeah.
And they're being shut out. It's not fair.
Yeah, it's not a mandatory externship. You can if you want to. This is, we've got some stats about ICE's legal team. They've got 1,200 attorneys, 300 support staff. It covered over 900,000 hearings in 2017. Turns out immigration law is a big practice. Our government is involved in it. Yet the first statement I read, I'm still stuck on it. Your school says that, no, you're being trained to be a peacemaker. Well, I thought you were being trained to follow the law and the Constitution.
Well, absolutely, and there's really no respect for that. You know, what about my thing with the peacemaker issue is, what about not everybody that's crossing our borders illegally is a peacemaker? So really, if we want to enforce our borders, we have to we need lawyers to be able to help support those ICE agents and enforce our law, and especially here in Washington State, where we're a border state, we have really large ports. ICE needs legal externs to be able to assist them in combating these really serious issues that really affect our community here. So to me, it really is just a political maneuver by Seattle U, and it's just really unfortunate and honestly embarrassing as a student to have just another political decision made by this administration.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, Thomas. It's not surprising. I've taught in academia. I know how this works in terms of the manipulation and trying to get their message across. But ICE actually issued a statement as well saying it's disheartening that an institution dedicated to teaching the laws of this country and whose core values include justice and diversity would prevent its students from gaining valuable professional experience. I tend to agree with that, and I'm guessing you do as well.
Yeah, I do. And, you know, it's just really sad because the school's ranking has dropped. And since 2012, we were ranked in the low 80s. Last year, we were ranked 128. And so we've fallen 40 some odd spots in the last 5 years. And in large part, because they're not focusing on the rule of law, they're not focusing on training students to have experiences that will actually help them in the real world. They're focusing on racial justice book trainings and clubs and gender and the law. I mean, I had to fight to get a basic tax class offer offered this next semester. That's the kind of, those are the kind of classes that are going to help me, not these social justice oriented, random sort of classes.
So a basic tax class.
Yeah, that's
amazing.
That's what happens.
Thomas, you just, I have a feeling you just made yourself a lot more popular on campus. I just want you to know that. In one way or another.
Yeah, only one semester to go, so hopefully not too much longer. But
good luck. Keep us posted, Thomas. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for being here.
Appreciate it.